When I come back from my job, I stay with them almost the how say the evening and all the night. But
That makes sense.
Silvana take care of them on weekends.
That's very, very Jesus. Exhausting.
Yeah. No, not
Dude.
too much. The problem is that they want to play all the time. So it's 3 a.m. and they are playing or and destroying things while I'm trying
No.
to sleep.
Dude. Yeah, and you're working and they're sleeping.
Yeah,
That's the opposite.
exactly.
Yeah, that happens. That happens. Pets. Well, for unfortunately, I cannot have pets here. They're not allowed here.
In the place where you
The
live.
new place.
Yeah.
I cannot have them.
Pet.
Yeah. So that was it. That was a destination coming into place.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, let's work. We left some stuff yesterday, and how did you feel after we finished yesterday's task where we were actually understanding phrases and the short version of them? What was your impression on yesterday's?
Well, I think that it's something difficult. You know, the first part to identify the exact words that the video is saying, but this is the exercise that we have been doing for the last months. So it's something really helpful, especially now that I took the TOEIC exam. But the second part of make like a summary of the phrase. It's interesting. So I think that the exercise that we did on Monday was most difficult because I didn't understand very well the purpose at the beginning, but yesterday was easier.
Correctly.
Well,
Yeah.
I understand the exercise, but it was not easier because it's something a little difficult.
Yeah, I mean, it's not easy
But
because we need to do a lot of things, but at least you are understanding why it's important to make divisions. No?
yeah.
Now, the summary looks much easier. Much, much
Yes.
easier. So I want you to develop the ability to do the summary by yourself. You know, without the need of a teacher. So that's what we're gonna do. Now, let's work on that. Okay, let's work on
Yeah.
question three. Question three said, what happened in 1971? It's slide number 486. 400 and... Eighty-four, no, 400, bro. What are you doing? And it's turn of number three. Okay, what happened in 1971? Remember, you have to build the main sentence first, or whichever. You can do the short one first. The idea is that you catch. Nouns first, right? Let's find the answer first.
One of the early SUVs was the Chevy Blazer, built on the frame of the Chevy S10 truck. This is the traditional definition of an SUV, if it was built on the frame of a truck. And to meet the legal definition of a light truck, it had to have some clearance angles and dimensions just right.
Taking a utilitarian vehicle and turning it into a almost a premium luxury device that happened to be utilitarian. Then comes the Grand Cherokee.
The Jeep Grand Cherokee was built the way passenger cars are, in one piece, or unibody. These two types of car constructions, frame-based and unibody, today form the distinction between traditional SUVs and the new, increasingly popular category of crossover.
They're more efficiently packaged, you don't have the frame.
The Grand Cherokee was part of the early success story of SUVs in the 90s and 2000s, one that continues today. This bias towards light trucks is why a company like Volkswagen, which once sold primarily passenger cars, has discontinued a lot of them today, like the Passat, in favor of SUVs and crossovers. And they've stopped producing all of their wagons, including the Jetta wagon I'm in. And a company like Ford has stopped producing all of their passenger cars except for the iconic Mustang. Okay, I'm gonna see if anyone at this car dealership will talk to me.
Buick was always car, really. That was mostly sedans. And then just with the market shift, we actually don't even sell a Buick sedan anymore. They don't even make a Buick sedan. It's all S crossovers.
When was the last time you guys carried like a Buick passenger car?
It was like 3 or 4 years ago.
And how many did you have on the lot?
Like 1 to 100 of SUVs. We're here to sell cars, but we want to sell what people want. If they were here and people didn't want them, I'm glad they're not here anymore, you know?
So this chart starts to make a lot more sense. 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed, the same ones that didn't apply as strictly to SUVs and trucks.
And that's the answer, but it's not the one 1971, it's 1975. There we go. So help me. Okay. Number one, Sylvana.
Wagons were passed. 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed.
I heard something like 1975 was the year these fuel, I don't know if the video says economic standards. Or, well, I didn't pay attention in that phrase because I was trying to remember how to write 1975. I know. I'm sorry.
Like the missing pants, no?
That's okay. the missing pants? What do you say?
It's like the music band, no?
1975. Ah, yes, like the music band. Yeah. That would be a help.
Yeah, Silvana know them.
Mm-hmm. Knows. No,
Silvana knows them, yeah.
Right. So that was a nice reference. But of course, I know that now thinking in cars, it's very difficult to associate one and the other. So yeah, 1975. Yeah. Be careful with those numbers.
But, okay.
Second place, huh? Second play. Let's go.
The same 1975 was the...
anymore, you know?
So this chart starts to make a lot more sense. 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed.
These few economic standards?
Mm-hmm. Sounds similar. Continue.
Or wagons? Wagons were passed.
Right. You know what's wagon?
No.
Does anybody know?
Is it a kind of car?
Yes, you're close.
Is the... No, the
like a truck.
A car from Volkswagen?
No. Actually, the word Volkswagen is a variety. It's a German word for big car, something like that. Because wagon is a derivative, like technically English is a derivative of German because of story. So some of the words are going to look similar, but they're not going to be the same. Like cognates in Spanish is not the same to say actually than to say actualmente. You know what I mean? Or you don't know what I mean? Yes, I know what you mean. Okay, anyway. Wagon, a railway truck for carrying goods.
Okay, it's like the, yes. But for example, in the subway, does it have the same name or is it different?
Exactly. It's a wagon.
Okay.
They're wagons. Freight is like cargo. So when you're talking about freight cars, you're talking about trains that don't transport people.
Okay.
But in general, the name is wagon because it's to carry stuff. Anyway, there's another definition. A vehicle with four wheels pulled by horses. No. A small table on very small wheels using for carrying of or serving food. Yeah, no, forget it.
Like the waiters and waitress.
No. It's a, well, probably in very fancy restaurants, yes. I was thinking more like in Harry Potter
In airplanes.
and airplanes, exactly. That they're
Okay.
carrying the little wagon and the trolley with sodas and stuff.
Okay.
So wagons were passed. So then when you hear the word wagon, we are not talking about the car per se. You're talking about the section of the car that you use to carry stuff.
Okay,
For example,
like
this section.
in the pickups, no?
Exactly. The
Yeah.
pickup has a wagon, while a sedan has a trunk.
What's that trunk?
What's equivalent to a wagon, but for a sedan that you
Okay.
close.
Okay. Yeah.
No?
I get it.
Trunk versus wagons, those are the differences. Let's go again, right? Silvana, you got your second
This
chance. Let's go to the
was my second.
Let's go to the third one.
Crossover.
Sell a Buick.
Did you have on the lot?
Like 1 to 100 of SUVs. We're here to sell cars, but we want to sell what people want. If they were here and people didn't want them, I'm glad they're not here anymore, you know?
So this chart starts to make a lot more sense. 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed, the same ones that didn't apply as strictly.
Not economic.
No, I didn't catch.
Anything?
I don't know if it's something like feast. No, this feast.
Feast.
Yeah, I don't know why I heard that. And between standard, there I think that is standards and wagons.
Standards in one, yes, but it's not and,
Oh,
milady. No, okay, it's
standards.
standard, it's and, but it's not connected to like it's, there are more information. Okay. You see what I
What?
mean?
Yeah,
I mean, in the
but
word,
two words?
in wagons, no more than two. So let's keep it over here. We need help to discover the rest of the information, guys. What about Elsie, can you participate or are you driving?
I'm driving, I just heard.
Cool. So keep up with us. Isaac, you're next.
Okay. I have 1975 was the year. This I'm not sure about this that word. 1975 was the year. This I think it must be plural, no? Because we are talking
Very
about
good.
standards. This,
Very good.
this,
Oh
this,
no,
this.
the second pronunciation is better.
This, no? The because
Nice.
the one that is writing them is this.
Is this, and that doesn't match the audio.
Uh-huh.
Oh, we can finally talk. Nice. Good. Very nice. So 1975 was the year these plural.
Yes,
Something.
and I didn't understand the next word. It's like feel, but I
You give
didn't.
me a synonym, I can give you the word. If you
Okay.
don't know the synonym, then we need to keep listening.
Okay. Yeah. And there's others. This. I don't know. Standards for is
Four, yes.
for or I just realized that I don't have the next word.
That's cool.
Okay.
That's cool.
Stand
Yes, listen.
for standards and. And what else were passed? Yes, that's it. That's all I have.
Awesome. Okay, no problem. Let's listen again. Let's go.
Economy. So this chart starts to make a lot more sense. 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed. This
I hear check was is I'm not sure if it is something like feel, but I think it's a verb, no? Feel. Then I think that it's a synonym of gasoline, like fuel. I
Yes,
don't know how to pronounce it.
I
Fuel.
can give you. I can give it to you. Very good. The synonym of gasoline, as you said.
Fuel.
Your pronunciation is correct.
Okay, fuel.
Fuel.
Fuel. Fuel.
Like there is an additional
Fuel.
fuel. Fuel.
Fuel. Fuel. Okay.
Right? Fuel is gasoline and. Or is a source of energy because it's not necessarily gasoline. Like gasoline is a type of fuel.
Okay.
But there are different types of fuel, such as carbon,
Okay.
coal, even water can be fuel. You know?
Okay.
Steam. Steam is a fuel. So these.
Yes. And let me check. Smokers. No, I am reading the second question. Was fuel economy? Oh, okay, let me check it. It doesn't make sense. Was the year this film economy standards?
Economy. Very good. What's the difference between economy and economic?
Economy is like the subject, no? I think.
Mm-hmm.
An economic, I'm not sure. Is it an adjective?
Economic is an adjective. Yeah, correct. Because economy is a blue word,
Is that now? What?
it's a noun, and economic needs a noun. So, how do you
Now?
use economic?
Oh,
No,
I don't know.
needs a noun. Needs a noun because it's an adjective.
Okay, yeah.
Then, okay, that would be something to read to Silvana because we were a little bit confused on that word. Silvana. Yes, you. What did you say? Oh, yeah, go.
Economic.
Econ. The strong
Yeah.
syllable is a.
Economic,
Exactly.
economic,
Economic.
economic. B1, only before noun, connected with the trade, industry, and development of wealth of a country, an area, or a society. They discussed social, economic, and political issues. Economic growth, development.
You see how we are talking about like matters? Economic growth, economic development, economic issues. You see?
Yeah.
That case it will be very different than say economic standards. Because standards are not economic. That would sound like standards are cheap. You know what I mean?
And they are not.
Exactly. We cannot buy standards. We are talking about standards of the economy. Substituting the connector of, you need to switch. Like the restaurant of McDonald's, McDonald's restaurant. Standards of the economy standards. We are replacing the connector of.
Yes.
That's all right. Finally, give me the mysterious word tilde. 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for blah and wagons. We're talking about fuel economy standards. What word should be there? What's missing?
I don't know, I didn't catch it. It
But
have to be
try to
an
guess it. It ha it has to be. Has to be,
it
not
has
have to.
to be a noun also.
Okay, and more giving context and understanding the sentence,
It
what
could be
word?
sedan.
Exactly. That's correct. It could be sedan. So let's listen.
1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed.
Did you hear?
It's very fast.
But what word did you hear? Or you didn't hear the word at all?
I hear something.
She vanished. Okay, so let's wait for her. Isaac, what word did you hear?
Four seven seven.
See the answer. Very good.
Yes, but it was a little difficult because I hear something like standards again or stand
All right.
stands, I think stands.
I'm going to help you why. The reason we are not understanding this word, because it dance, is because we are pronouncing many letters as in Spanish. Considering American pronunciation, in the word sedan, sedan, the letter number one, the letter D, d doesn't, shouldn't sound like a Spanish d. Daniela, Damaris, Donna. You know what I mean? Like the word in Spanish, Donna, is spelled and has the same alphabet as donut, d-d-d-donut, but the pronunciation of the letter T is very different. Hard to pronounce it yourself. Some for some for some door. Check this out.
D. Say that with me. D.
Come on, everybody. D.
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 Can you repeat it?
D. 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 D.
D. Say that with me. D.
That sounds better, Isaac. That sounds much better.
It's like Daniel. Daniel. D.
Kinda, because now you transform again to the Spanish da 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 da. That's English.
Okay.
Da 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 da.
The.
Which sounds very similar to T.
T. Say that with me.
Right.
T.
Actually, that's the reason. That's the reason that they are together in my soundboard. Here, these two are parallel because the one on top is the same position, but with different activation of the voice. If you pronounce the T with no voice, you will hear ta, ta, ta. It's an explosion. Ta, ta. Right? Now, pronounce the same sound, but do it with a vibration. Ta, ta, ta. That sounds better. That sounds better. Now, avoid putting that tongue in the middle. Don't do this. This is incorrect. Okay? Because then you are pronouncing the there. They. That. Those. TH. So let's try again. Everybody. That's better, Isaac. Okay, again. That sounds better. Yeah. Contrast. That. That. Data. Data. Come on, Dara.
Dara.
Oh, sorry. Dara.
Dara, no. In Spanish, Dara, no. Da. Dara.
Dara.
Okay. Contrast. They.
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 Okay. Contrast. Day. Day.
Day.
Day. What's the difference?
What is what we sorry, I thought it was a question.
No, yes, it's a question. What's the difference?
One is like vibration, if you let a little bit air, like crossing, and the other you do not. I don't know how to explain.
Correct. The green one, it has a blockage. Duh, duh, duh. No?
Yeah.
And the pink one has a vibration. That would be the difference between they. Versus they. The only difference is here. Pronounce both. Let's start with Isaac. How do you pronounce the first one?
They.
They, correct. That's a vibration, a constant vibration. This is the pink one.
The second one is they.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Make a blockage. Day.
They.
Right.
They.
Exactly. Sounds good.
Okay, yes. The first one has like a vibration at the beginning, no? Second one is like more
flow.
Like more something clear or I don't know how to explain.
Mm-hmm. There's air coming out and it's more constant.
Yeah.
They. And the second one, there's no vibration. It's your voice, but there's a duh and like a little explosion. Duh. Day. Right? That's the reason we couldn't understand. What am I sharing? Yeah, we couldn't understand sedan. Sedan. The other difference is a. Do you agree? A very
Yes.
precision. Sedan.
You repeat it? Sedan?
It's not say. Sedan.
Sedan.
Exactly. Damn.
Sedan. Sedan.
Right.
Sedan. Okay.
It's very important, you know what? That when you're talking in English, don't be afraid to sound fresa. I think that's something very important, because if we fresas talk like that, because they usually share their time with American people, or they have family with American people. Entonces, las personas así que traen algo gringo, se me olvida cómo decir algo en inglés, ¿sabes? The mouth is using that muscle. There's a different muscle there, you know? A different use of the mouth, which is very similar to Spanish, to English, sorry. Right? That is a famosa papa en la boca. It's English. It's English accent. Which is right here. So let's sit down. That vowel is a very, very, very American transition, you know? So don't be afraid to sound like that. Just exaggerate. That's okay. If you're talking English, it's very normal. If you're talking Spanish, well, control yourself. But in English, it's very, very normal. So again, sedan.
Sit down.
Sedan.
Sedan.
That sounds good. That sounds good. Yeah. Sedan.
Sedan.
Nice, Isaac. Sylvana? Sedan.
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 Okay, interesting.
That's your natural way of speaking.
Nah, I learned it. I learned it with the time. You know, I learned it after learning English, you start talking like this, you know. But that's
you
not
used
true.
To live in Colonia del Valle.
Well,
Obviously, that's your natural accent.
Yes,
I am. Now,
I live in Iztapalapa.
No, no, no. You speak like that and you know, no cell phone. Yes. When I visit Iztapalapa, I control my accent. So, I understand your problem. I really understand. But it's not impossible. So yeah, that's a part, okay? That's a part of pronunciation. That's part, second part. In 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed. And then?
The same ones that didn't apply as strictly to SUVs and trucks.
That's important. Go to Lena.
It says something like the frame one sedan. Sedan? No.
Sounds good. Sounds good. Yes, I like it. I like it. The something once,
Sorry, I forgot. It's because my computer
froze.
Just died. Yeah, and I have to be on my cell phone, and you ask me quickly, and I
Okay.
couldn't take notes. Let me put my notes.
Okay.
Okay, can you repeat the video?
Sure.
Wagons were passed, the same ones that didn't apply as strictly to SUVs and trucks.
Okay, no, I didn't catch anything. Because sorry, I can see the lesson and also take notes. So I don't know why I write wagons were passed. The
Yeah, that was the previous idea.
yeah, sorry.
Final comments. You have one more chance. Okay.
Okay. Well,
Wagons were passed, the same ones that didn't apply as strictly to SUVs and trucks.
Okay, something like the same ones, sedans, SUVs, and trucks.
Repeat.
Yes, I think that the video says the same ones, sedans, SUVs, and trucks.
Sounds good. What's missing?
Verb.
Right, very good. Find the verb. Isaac, do you have the verb? I think
Maybe.
it didn't apply. Yes. Yes. Confirmation.
Wagons were passed, the same ones that didn't apply as strictly to SUVs and trucks.
Read the sentence, Isaac. Since once there is a word for, right? The same one didn't apply as something to SUVs and trucks. I didn't hear sedans.
I don't remember. But what is the connector that you said?
Ouch! Sorry, but Kiren is aggressive sometimes. The same that didn't apply. As didn't apply as something. And I didn't hear sedans. Sedans. Sorry. Sedans.
Sounds good. Excellent.
Yeah.
Something else. Okay, but you omitted the connector that you said before. What's a cookie for apply?
Apply to?
That's correct. Word two is right. Word sedan, we're gonna check if it's correct or not, and we're gonna check the rest. Let's
Okay.
listen again.
Wagons more sense. The same ones that didn't apply as strictly to SUVs and trucks.
Right, and they never say sedan.
Yes, only SUVs and trucks.
And trucks.
They didn't apply strictly. I don't know.
Exactly. Strictly. We have a decoration there. Didn't apply strictly to SUVs and trucks. And what about the mysterious word?
The same ones. No, I don't have it.
Ask yourself, what's missing? Understand the sentence.
The same ones didn't apply strictly to sales and trucks.
When you say once, what are you talking about?
The economy standards.
Economy standards. So the same economy standards, space didn't apply.
Is it something like what would it be like which or
Correct. Yes,
that?
you need an extender. You need an extender, but it's not which. You're
Mm-hmm.
close, you're close, you're closer. Hot, hot, hot.
Okay. Come on.
There's one
Final,
last.
final repetition.
Okay.
Wagons were passed, the same ones that didn't apply as strictly to SUVs and trucks.
No, no, I couldn't understand it.
No?
No.
Okay, interesting. Silvana, do you have it?
No, for a moment I thought it was set. Because we talk about set of rules.
That saying one set, yeah, but if you say once, you cannot say set.
Yeah.
I mean, you can say the same set, but if you remove once.
Yeah, it's because I thought that maybe it was the same one set, and I understand what once
Anyway,
because it was.
the same problem.
Okay.
You cannot say the same one set. You know, or you can say it, but that's not common. As the
It
number
sounds
one,
good.
right? Yeah, probably some person has said it, but if you use one as a pronoun, you cannot say it. Anyway, in this case, one is replacing fuel economy standards. So the validation is before. And that can help you understand that it's not set. Any idea of an extender? Isaac was really close. He said, you need which. The same ones which didn't apply. Grammatically, that matches, but that doesn't match the audio. So find another extender to replace which. That's the only extender that is possible to use. Anyone? Isaac and Silvana. Silvana and Isaac. Come on, you can do this.
Did I say which right?
You said which.
Okay.
You said which? That's wrong. No?
No.
No.
Christ, people, I'm gonna kill you both. Look at this. Tip of extenders, Isaac.
Tips of extenders that can be replaced with who and which. Then is that.
And vice versa.
Okay.
Okay, now let's check if it matches the audio.
Okay.
Make a lot more sense. 1975 was the year these fuel economy standards for sedans and wagons were passed, the same ones that didn't apply as strictly to.
You don't know.
Yes, but I think that the speaker says it so fast, no?
Yeah. Also, you know what happens in American English? When they say that or the word ends in T, they
mm-hmm.
omit the last T.
The?
No, they omit the
oh.
T, not the A. So it's that.
The. Okay.
Very, very open. That
the.
Didn't.
And then, so it's like together.
That didn't. Imagine the first D in didn't gets together with that. That didn't.
That didn't.
That didn't.
Okay. And hashtag we are done. Good job, good job. Okay, let's play the Pokemon level up sound and let's pass to Jesse because Jesse's the chat. Hello, Jesse.
Hello, teacher. Good
Hi.
night. Good night, everyone. So, I will take attendance. Is he Silvana? Hello, sir. Good night.
Hello, Jesse. Good night.
Thank you, Sil. And Isaac. Hello, Isaac. Good night.
Hello.
So, that's all. Okay.
That's
Bye.
all, lady. Elsie came, but she was driving, so she probably lost connection.
All right. Yes. So I will send the class.
Thank you, girl.
Yes. Thank you, teacher. Good night. Good night,
Good night.
everyone. Have a good
Do
night.
the best.
Thank
Bye.
you.
Bye.
Bye bye.
Isn't she adorable? I think she is. We finished, guys. Do you have any question?
Not sure. It was hard.
It was her. Now it was a pronunciation issue, but it's about paying attention to those details that we are not, or we are discovering. You
Yeah,
know,
they speak super fast.
yeah, they do.
Doors and some words, maybe. Well, yeah, the pronunciation. We are not taking care of the correct pronunciation, but also they are super fast. And maybe we used to say that those words a little more slowly. No, just slowly.
Slowly, yeah. It's a combination of speed and pronunciation affecting
Yeah.
comprehension. Because they're way going too fast, and we go too slow. And they're using real pronunciation, and we are pronouncing as we have done all our life. So what we have to do is to change a little bit the pronunciation, so we can discover words, and then adapt to the speed. And magically, everything connects.
Yes.
That's the reason transition is so important. And I love, for example, quick learnings. What's the
The
name
chart,
of it? The
color chart.
color chart. If they taught it correctly, that would be an amazing, amazing tool.
I think
But
that maybe the problem is that they get so used to teach that color, that chart, that it lost the sense. You have to practice it. At the beginning, at the end, and for every single word, it doesn't matter if the, well, if at the final, it doesn't matter if the student is telling the word correctly, because you have to go to the next word, to the next student. So I don't know,
Exactly.
just.
The pace goes so quickly that we cannot focus on these details in particular. That it doesn't matter how advanced we are, we can be studying C2 and we will still have pronunciation issues. And that
I think,
affects comprehension. That's always going to happen. Always,
yeah.
always. So that's natural. That's natural. That was a pretty interesting detail analysis.
Yeah.
So good. Very good, guys. Let's keep it over here. Let's go to rest. Good job. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you, teacher.
All right, teacher. I'll see you.
I can say
Are
bye-bye.
you available next Friday? I was thinking about to return your book.
Oh, okay. Cool. Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm
okay.
off.
I will send you a message.
Cool. Yeah, let me know. Right?
Okay, sure. Thank you.
Very good, brother. We'll see you later.
See
See
you.
you.
Bye. Bye.